Hey everybody, so I know I said I would talk about this topic last week, but you know, things have been busy. I've had so much going on, and yeah, so we're here now. We're here to talk about astral travel, journey. What I personally do, I'll just give a little definition of what I do, because all I can do is teach from my experience and what works for me. Everything's going to work a little differently for everybody, and you'll have to find what works best for you. So what I usually call myself is a hedge witch. A hedge witch, or a green witch and hedge witch. So I work with plants. I work with spirits as well. So a hedge witch is able to hedge cross. This is similar to what is done in animism in journey, in shamanism in journey, and astral travel. Astral travel, though, we'll get into that, exactly which of the worlds that has to do with. So in journey, like I do, I'll either go to the lower, middle, and upper worlds. Those are different worlds. Lower is not always bad. Upper is not always good. Middle is like the parallel to where we are right now. So let's talk about, all right, this might be kind of long. All right, let's talk about where I do most of my work, the lower worlds. So to get to the lower worlds, what I do is I will go to in my mind, I will allow my consciousness to leave my body through visualization. Make sure you are in a completely safe place. I recommend using some sort of instrument to help you go into that, like a percussion instrument. What I like to use is a Remo buffalo drum, and I need to post a picture of that on here too so that you can see what it is. The Remo buffalo drum is similar to the style of what you see as a traditional shamanic drum. It's going to be, it looks like the skin wrap over the wood, but the Remo buffalo drum that I use is not from an animal. That's why I use it. Okay, so what I do is I drum for myself. I started off by listening to other musics or other drumming, but I'll drum for myself. And that drumming has actually been proven, that beat, to get you into a delta state. So I'll usually drum in fours. You can look up this type of drumming online and get more information. I am not the one-stop shop for this. You want to look into a lot more from here, okay? So with the drumming, I'll do fours. I'll do like north, east, south, and west. I'm so sorry there's a beeping noise. We came to the park because there was construction at home, and now there's a beeping truck here. So I hope you don't hear it. So yeah, so I'll do like the north, east, south, west. Or I will do one, two, three, four. So the first one we're looking at, we're doing the beat to represent the directions. The second one, it's like the heartbeat, ba-bum, ba-bum, but it's one, two, three, four. You can use other music. Some people can do it without music. I prefer to do it with music. All right, this is important. So the reason I like to have music or drumming, some sort of cue, specific type of music, especially the drumming, because I don't want to go off into that journey state or that travel state at an unsafe time. I want to do it when I know it's set. This is my boundary of it. This is when I'm going to come back to my body. This is where I am, what I'm doing. You obviously would not want to astral travel or do journey from your car. That would be from driving, you know, or even from your car at all, because it's just not safe. So, yeah. And the lower worlds, I'll visualize a spring, a body of water, or even going down a tree's roots of something that I have seen before and is special to me. I will not share the location, but I have a very special power location to me that I went to when I was young, and it is where I do the majority of my lower world journeys from, because it is such a powerful spiritual place to me, and it's a huge, deep, dark spring. So what I will do, I will leave with that visualization of it, my consciousness coming out of the body, or you can just immediately visualize your consciousness at that area, so at that spring. This is just an example. You could also go down the roots of a tree or something like that. There's other options too. So this is just some. So I'll go to that spring. I'll swim, 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 swim down. And at the bottom, it's like I go through a little, like, I guess you could call it portal. So I go through and I'm out and I come back and you're like up on the other side. Okay, I hope you're following. So I come up and I'm standing up straight. It's not like I'm upside down and shit. Okay, so I'm standing up straight. And I get up and I'll start walking around, and I always have an intention before I do this. So I might be like, okay, I want to work with a certain power animal, or I want to work with the spirits of the land in this location, that location, or I want to meet with my spirit guides and want a certain message. Spirit guides, I usually do that more so in the upper worlds, but you can do it in the lower or the middle. Like, you know, do more research on your own about that. This video can only be so long. And yeah, so I'm in the lower worlds. It's usually like, for me, I'll come out of a cave. It'll be a little darker, more dreamy, more mystical. I might be in like a lagoon, but sometimes I've come out down there and it's been more of like just a green area. But it's usually a lot of like green, or like could be at a volcano site or someplace dark as well. Dark doesn't always mean evil. I'm just meaning, you know, darker. Hey, Ginger. My puppy. So yeah, I hope that makes sense for the basics of the lower worlds, and that's where I feel most comfortable. And I'll even honor my ancestors there. It's big for me, honoring my ancestors, my power animals. Big one for me. Okay, so next we're gonna talk about the middle world. Middle world is kind of just like a reflection of here where we're at right now, but we cross through the veil. All right, we are here, but we can cross through the veil. And the veil could be described as like the cover on the this is hard to explain in like words, on the dimension that is like what could be called the matrix, or what could be called what we view this world as. And so we go beyond that and we can get into like the spirit world, and we can talk to, that's a really, middle worlds are probably an amazing place actually to work with ancestors, and I've done that before too. And middle worlds is where you're going to work with the spirit of the land usually. So say I want to work with the spirit of the land where I live. All right, so I'm gonna visualize myself. I'll be laying, well, I don't always lay down. I'll dance and drum. So you gotta find what works for you. Some people will lay down, or I'll be up. I'll be moving. I'll be dancing with my drum. I might be chanting. It might be, you know, doing all that. And I'm gonna make a rattle too. Rattles can be used as well. And yeah. So when you're sourcing tools, drums, rattles, make sure it's ethically sourced. Definitely look into that. If you can make it yourself, that is the best thing. So my rattle, I'll be making myself. Hoo-hoo. Little offshoot onto musical instruments. But I also have a steel tongue drum, which is fun. I don't use that for journey though. That's more spiritual practice. Anyways, so I'm going into the middle world. So I'm gonna get up, visualize myself coming out of my body, walking out. I'm gonna walk out my door. You know, it's the room just like how it is. I'm walk out the door, and as I leave, I'm crossing through the veil. Okay. And I'll have my intention. So my intention could be, I want to meet the spirits of the land here. I want to introduce myself to the spirits of the land here. I want them to know that I am here with love. I want to understand them. I want to hear the history. I want to know about the people of this land, ancestors of this land, or talking to deceased loved ones. Always be careful. Like, a lot of the stuff you want to study and understand before you do. Okay? So, like, you know, like, it's... You want to be ready before you do all this. It's taken me a lot of times. I know I'm very young, but I started really strict research into different spiritual practices at a very young age, freshman year of high school. I'm 22 right now. I am still young. I am still learning. I still definitely have so much more to learn, okay? But be ready. Be smart. If you can work with somebody, that's even better, okay? So then when I'm going to the middle worlds, all right. Or from the middle worlds, I can go visit a friend somewhere else in the world, you know? Like, say they're over in Honduras or China or Britain. I'm gonna travel there. So I'm gonna visualize leaving my room, leaving my body, going out the door, or I like to go out the window. So, 'cause yeah. So I'll go out the window and I'll fly up. And this is what's more so known as astral travel. What I'm talking about with the flying through the middle world. This is what is usually referred to as astral travel in different spiritual sects right now, modern times. Okay, so we're gonna fly to where that person is. We're gonna go see them. If you're visiting somebody like that's currently alive, get permission. Even if you're visiting an ancestor, please ask first. Or even if you're visiting the spirits of the land, ask first. So if you're going to visit the spirits of the land, you're going to visit ancestors, somebody who's passed away, spirits of a tree, spirits of something, ask permission first. Say, may I step into your field of energy, so that you're not just forcing yourself in there and you don't get yourself into trouble. Be safe. And yeah. And you don't even have to, if you don't know what you're doing, it's probably best not to work with the spirits yet, obviously. You can just go see stuff, or, I don't know, do you want to go see the pyramids in Egypt? Go. Go through the middle world, go there. Do it. You want to go to the Grand Canyon? Do it. You can do it. Like, it's all in here, your consciousness. You can just, you can do whichever you want. You can go wherever the fuck you want. Okay, it'll take practice, and you may not get it your first time or your first three times. It might take you a lot of practice, more research, more studying. Spirit Science is a great resource for learning this type of thing. They've got astral travel, they've got dream work, and if you go through there, they, in their videos on it, they give a lot of information. Okay, so yeah, so we've done that. We've covered the middle worlds. Upper worlds. Okay, so the upper worlds, that's gonna be, for example, Wizard of Oz. In the Wizard of Oz, Dorothy gets onto a tornado and goes up into the other realm, okay? Or we can climb up a tree, climb up a real tall tree and go up from there. These are some really tall trees. Or sometimes I'll climb up a tree and I'll visualize ladders, and I'll climb these ladders into the clouds. And with each of these, there's layers to it. So there's layers to the upper worlds, layers to the lower worlds, layers to the middle world. Okay? And in the Wizard of Oz, she goes into a crystal city. So there are cultures that have done this type of journey work, especially in Europe, where the Fae are very well known and believed, where they've gone, and they've gone to those crystal cities and that type of thing. Or you can go through the cloud worlds, or you can go through, it's like these higher upper dimensions that are, it's hard to describe because it's so not physically grasped in this 3D human body, you know? Okay, so we've done that. Working on your opening up your third eye chakra, opening up that, whether you want to call it a chakra or not, whatever, opening up your third eye. There is a actual pineal gland in your brain. It resembles an eye. It has the, it can create light and color in there, okay? It's got crystals in there. It's got lenses in there. It is like an eye inside your brain. So the spiritual idea of the third eye chakra or pineal gland, you know, that comes from the pineal gland. Or the crown. So the crown, basically that energy center up here that we can connect to the higher, connect to divinity, connect to that higherness, okay? Higherness, that's not a word. But whatever, I make up my words. We are doing what we want here, right? We make up our words. I don't know what I'm saying. Whatever. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I made this for this Facebook group, but if you're watching from YouTube, please subscribe, share, like, whatever. If you like it, if you don't like it, then don't, because whatever, but you wouldn't have gotten this one video if you didn't like it anyway. Okay, or you can find me on Instagram at Earth Goddess Lotus. You can find me on Instagram at Lotus Holistic Healing for my herbal business, health business. And I think that's what we have here. Recap real quick, or just like a real thing, real whatever. Note that you want to make sure you're safe. You want to make sure you're in a safe place, safe environment. And you know what you're doing, you know what you're getting yourself into. Don't go up to unknown spirits that are like if you're unexperienced, if you're very experienced, okay, whatever, you know what you're doing. But you, when you're starting off, you want to make the intention to not even see that. You don't even have to see those. You can do protection spells, you can do protection magic, you know, that type of thing. So, all right. Thanks, guys, so much for listening. Love you. Peace, love, joy, abundance, wealth, happiness, health, all the best things coming your way, coming to you. Love you.